Welcome back to Arise and Shine. Lacey Schwartz always felt different than the other kids, and when she finally confronted her mother, she discovered the shocking reason why. She tells her story in the compelling new documentary, Little White Lie. Welcome, Lacey. We're so excited to have you.
Yeah. Thank you for having me. Hello.
First of all, tell us about your film and what's it about.
So the film is about dual identity and family secrets. I grew up in a white Jewish family and found out at the age of 18 that my biological father was black. My mother had an affair and no one talked about it.
Whoa.
So the film follows my journey and process to uncover my family secrets and learn how to connect my dual identities of being black and Jewish.
Yeah.
And how did you find out exactly that, you know, you had this black father?
You know, one of the things that the film follows is kind of my discovery from a very young age that I'm different, and it's coming at me in so many different ways. And then as I get older and start a variety of different things happen, my parents split up, my world kind of comes apart. And I eventually went away to college, to Georgetown, where they had, just based off of a photograph, admitted me as a black student.
Oh, wow.
And I slowly started questioning more and more, and I finally came home at the end of my freshman year of college and questioned my mother about why I looked the way I did.
Yeah.
And
so
she told you the truth.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We were just looking at footage of it as well. Of course, you, compared to your mother, you looked darker skinned as well, so that must have been a hint. Did you know who your father was?
When I asked my mother at the age of 18, that's when I found out. I did know him. My biological father was actually somebody I knew. He was kind of like an old quote-unquote family friend, somebody my mother had known for a long time, and he was kind of around.
Yeah.
Amazing. And so what about the father who actually raised you? Mm-hmm. Did he know about this?
You know, I think one of the big pieces of my story, and I think it's relatable to a lot of different stories, is the power of denial and how often we can really make ourselves believe what we want to believe. And I think everyone in my family had their own timeline of denial, including myself and including my father. So eventually he kind of put it all together, but there was many years that he believed it. There was, in particular, and the film gets into this in depth, of kind of how does this happen? Mm-hmm. Because I think these kind of family secrets, people creating their own reality, it happens all the time. And the question is, how does that happen? And so that's one of the things I really wanted to delve into. And in particular, there was, my father had a grandfather who was dark-skinned Sicilian, and people thought, oh, well, Lacey just looks like recessive genes, that kind of thing.
Now, you know, your mom was, of course, in a really awkward situation, in a dilemma, we could put it. Did she have second thoughts? How did she deal with it?
You know, I think my mother kind of kept her blinders on and kept an eye. I think she was trying to do a lot at the same time. It's so ironic because she's such an amazing mother, but also made so many mistakes. And, you know, this film, so much about it is about the power of having difficult but important conversations and moving past these secrets, and it's been incredibly healing for us, in particular for my mother and I.
Yeah, a very therapeutic process. And so, obviously, this is your life story. I mean, how long did it actually take you to make the film?
I worked on the film for 8 years. We kind of developed it for 2, shot it for 3, and then we edited it for 3.
Wow.
It was definitely quite a process.
So how did you break down the stages of denial in this film?
So the way I look at denial is, again, more than we lie to other people, we lie to ourselves first. And so the first stage of denial is really when you can convince yourself to believe what you want to believe. The second stage, the way I look at it, is that at a certain point, you deep down know the truth, but then you are still not ready to admit it to yourself. And then the third stage is when you know the truth, you're just not ready to talk to anybody else about it. And I think that's really the crux of family secrets, is when people, everybody knows the truth, but nobody's talking about it.
Right. Well, it's amazing that you're able to use this documentary as a platform to talk about that, I think.
Yeah,
exactly.
So you've been encouraging people to share their own family secrets on the film's website. And I know that you've gotten a lot of feedback from people. Like, what other stories have you learned by sharing your own story?
I mean, there's so, and that was one of the things we really want to do, is it's not just about my story. It's really using the film as a tool to get other people to talk about their stories and to heal, have constructive conversations about it. And it can be anything from issues of race, like mine, paternity, sexuality, all different kinds of issues within families. It's amazing how many there are.
Yeah. Tell us about the cultural dialogue that started through this film.
Yeah, we're doing all sorts of different programs, that really using the film as an educational tool. We've been just went to the Israel with the U.S. State Department to show the film to all sorts of different groups in Israel, both Arabs and Jews, and allow it to, you know, build conversation around. We're working with the Sundance Institute, the program called Film Forward about advancing cultural dialogue. We're going to be doing the same thing, bringing the film into all different sorts of communities to have these conversations. So it's really exciting, and that's a great part of it. We really want to work with as many schools, universities, community centers as possible.
Yeah. I think it's a story that's relatable to people around the world and in this country. You know, I mean, I think it happens more frequently than you would even imagine. You know?
Absolutely, and we have to destigmatize it, and we have to have healthy conversations about it. I always say that, really, how can we expect society to talk about these big issues and heal over them, like race and all these different things, if families can't even talk about them? So we have to support families having, you know, healthy conversations, and then it will really have implications for our larger society.
So, you know, you had those stages of denial where, you know, you didn't want to talk about it or you didn't want to accept it. But what ultimately motivated you to actually make the film?
I think what really motivated me was realizing that until I uncovered my family secrets and really dealt with them, I was never going to be able to fully move forward with my life. It was holding me back. I see way too many people who they carry their kind of baggage, really sometimes sadly until their grave, and it affects their lives in so many ways. And I didn't want to be a victim to a circumstance. I thought that there was a more productive and positive way to deal with it, even if it was going to be difficult and hard.
Yeah.
I'm very interested to know, for those people who did watch it, what's been the feedback?
I think the feedback, I mean, people, I've been incredibly honored that so many people have really appreciated the film, but the feedback has really depended on people's experience. It's like they connect into depending what they have experienced, and that's been amazing to see. It really is very, very subjective and personal.
Yeah, thanks very much for joining us. And
thank
of course,
you.
Your film really does speak to everyone. And sometimes we must have difficult conversations, right, in order to move forward. To find out more about Lacey Ann Little White Lies, go to littlewhitelies.thefilm.com or follow her on Facebook and Twitter. Be sure to tune into PBS on March 23rd to watch the documentary.
I'm looking forward to
it.
I can't wait. Well, we have much more coming up on the show. Up next, what you post on social media may come back to haunt you.
Ooh.
Social media strategist Ashani Mfuku will tell us the do's and don'ts when we return. Don't go away. You're watching Arise and Shine.